This is Spencer with the MacGuffin, and today I'm joined by Sam Elliott and Brett Haley. All right, I like to get things right. It seems deceptively simple.
It's the obvious choice, I think. When you see that, you're like, is that Haley? It's Haley. Yeah.
I feel like you could just really mess with people because of that. But you guys are here in Seattle for the, I guess, is this United States release or just Seattle release of the Hero or at SIFF?
It's a SIFF thing, I guess.
Okay. You guys are at SIFF for your newest film, The Hero. I can't help but feel a little bit of deja vu because you guys were here just, was it 2 years ago for I'll See You in My Dreams? So we got the band back together, as they say.
Yeah, we did.
Which is sort of one of the first places I want to start is the sort of chicken and egg sort of scenario here. Was it that you had an idea in your mind and went to Sam saying like, let's do this again, or were you just like, I have access to Sam Elliott, let me make a picture that I can really highlight his talents in?
Yeah, it was sort of a mix of both, but I think the movie, you know, people always say, well, how did you come up with this film, or what made you want to make The Hero? And it's Sam Elliott. Mark and I wanted to write something for Sam that was specific, that was a vehicle for him. And that's what we did. So, yeah, having access to him certainly helped. And that the fact that we had worked together previously and that we trusted each other as collaborators and friends. And so, I brought it straight to Sam and I told him straight up. I said, if you say no, I'm not going to make this with somebody else. So that was it.
Was it an easy sell?
No, I wouldn't have.
I mean, after you guys had worked together, was it an easy sell for him just to like, did you even read the script or were you just like, I trust you, I'm going
to
go with this?
It came to me first as a treatment, Spencer, and it was like so provocative and so like intriguing that I was like from the get-go interested. It was called Iceberg in the beginning.
That makes sense.
On a poster.
I don't know. The desktop background.
People would be a little bit confused at the end of the day.
It's much more metaphorical.
It's a cool title.
It does have its charm. Yeah,
Have its charm for sure.
It's an interesting thing for me is sort of like with a project like this, from your perspective, Sam, is it tougher to sort of work on a project which is more sort of ground in a reality of like you're getting older. I'm sure you've reflected on your career over time.
Sure.
And there's sort of like much more sort of personal touches of something like that, or like as your character is in the movie.
I think it makes it absolutely easier. You've kind of lived most of it.
But is that tough because like, I mean, it might, I mean, touch on things that are, I mean, you know.
No, because there's nothing really painful about it. There's stuff that's, again, provocative about it in terms of my life. But the most painful elements would be the relationship with the daughter, the divorce from the wife, the cancer diagnosis, and the unbridled dope and all that shit reference.
Yeah.
You know? And all those are contrivances.
Yeah, those are fictional.
So the rest of it's just fun.
Yeah.
I mean, I get to have a romance with the beautiful Laura Prepon and get to work with her as an actor. And I've always been a huge fan of hers.
Yeah, the cast is phenomenal.
Nick Offerman is a dear friend, and I love working with him. You know, Kristen Ritter was somebody I've admired from afar but never crossed paths with. And for her to play my daughter, I mean, it's just, I love the process. I love the process. And when you get a piece of material that is, like you say, kind of close to the bone, it just makes it sweeter on some level.
Is it more gratifying when it's something that you can sort of really relate to personally versus like something like in the movie when you're auditioning for this outlandish space action film or whatever? Or is it just like those are so outside the box that they're
it's been a while, but I've auditioned through the course of my career for some pretty outlandish shit, you know. So I get it.
What was it like in terms of developing the chemistry with the rest of the cast? I mean, there's a fairly small group of cast. You've worked with Nick before. Your wife is in the film.
Yeah.
But, like, I mean, obviously this is an independent film. You have a very limited amount of time to sort of develop those relationships and sort of get that sort of vibe going. It's all him.
Well, he sets the tone. He's the captain of the ship. You know, be mutiny if it wasn't the right tone, probably.
And you hope that you've you know, 90% of directing is casting. So you want to make sure you get it right. Because if you start piecing people together, it's like you can kind of just go, are these people going to work together? It's a weird pre-visualization of something. And I just remember when I came up with the Laura Prepon idea, which was my first idea for Charlotte, there was something, and I just said, this is going to work. I just said, something about it is going to work. And I called Sam and I said, I want to go out to Laura Prepon for Charlotte. And Sam just immediately went, yes, you nailed it. We just knew. And of course, you know, we had limited time, of course, and resources. But Laura and Sam in particular, actually all the actors, from Kristen to Catherine to Nick, we all sat down and did rehearsal, which is rare. Wow, all gave me their time to do that. They were very committed to this, and we would meet and talk. We had the most time with Laura because I was most concerned about, like, you know, Nick and Sam are friends in real life. That was going to be no problem. And Kristen and Sam played off each other beautifully. And that relationship, we're at an arm's length of that. That's not what the film is about. It's there and it needs to be there, but it's not the meat of the film.
There's an interesting sort of also dynamic, I guess, in some ways that it also helps if they're not super connected for that role.
Correct.
Because, like, I mean, inherently,
correct,
if they're too connected, it almost makes it wouldn't work.
Yeah.
Yeah, not work.
So we spent a lot of time with Laura and working on those scenes and blocking and rehearsing. And I think that's where it comes together. But it also just comes together because you get it right. And there's something magic about that. I can't really put my finger on it. Either two people are going to have chemistry or they aren't. You can't really fake it. So, well, we were lucky. And that's a tough relationship. That's not an easy relationship to depict. And I was very sensitive about it.
Is there something about sort of the process of, like, approaching death and reflecting on life that really sort of speaks to you? Because, I mean, I'll see you in my dreams.
Yeah.
Dreams. Is sort of like touching upon that as well. This sort of has that aspect of, like, somebody who sort of, like, I mean, got something in their life that makes them sort of reflect on where they are.
Yeah, they're different. I mean, dreams is about grief and loss.
Yes.
And this is not about grief and loss.
No, no.
But, I mean, both are about the age-old question of mortality.
Yes,
I mean,
exactly.
Which I think all great art at the end of the day has a piece of that, of letting go, of saying goodbye, of knowing that things end. There's a finality in this world, whether you like it or not, whether that comes to your relationships, whether that comes to your life. The one truth there – well, that's why you see the tax forms in the film. The only two things you can count on in this world are death and taxes. So, you know, I come to the place of this film is about legacy. It's about looking back on one's life and knowing, like, how the hell did I end up here and what does it all mean? It's about a man coming to terms with what a full life means. It's simple. There is a mortality aspect to that. But to me, the themes of this film and the themes of I'll See You in My Dreams are very different.
Oh, yeah. No, definitely.
Yeah.
I agree with that. And in terms of you working on this, Sam, did this sort of make you sort of reflect upon your legacy in Hollywood or just in acting in general, I guess would be a better way of describing it. And, I mean, honestly, do you even think about your legacy, or do you just sort of like say, like, I'm going to play the hands I'm dealt and leave the chips where they may at the end of the
day? Yeah, I don't think I think of it in terms of a legacy that I'm leaving. I mean, we obviously are leaving one on some level. But I also don't just play the hand that's dealt me. You know, I like to try to
control it,
be a little bit in control of my own destiny to a point. I mean, you can only control so much. But in terms of choices and that, I can make choices. You know what I mean?
I'm always fascinated by things like this. For somebody like you who's had so much diverse experience over the years, what is challenging when you approach a project like this? Is it all just like you're like easy for you at this point, or are there certain things even in films
difficult? It's not easy. I still go in nervous when I'm going to work, and you know. Trying to focus on it and forget about all the ancillary bullshit that we're surrounded with in life in general and in the movie business as well. You know, I'm doing this thing called a ranch that we're shooting in front of a four camera live audience Friday nights, and I go in there fucking just in knots, man, because I don't want to get up in front of a live audience particularly.
Sam cares a lot.
You know.
we talked about this yesterday, but we both get a little nervous because we care. We want to do a good job and we want it to be good. So we don't come in there we come in caring about what we're going to accomplish that day.
I think that's essential.
I think it is essential, but it's also about keeping the energy in a good place. So it's about harnessing that nervousness or that care or that anxiety that you might have about, are we going to do what we need to do today, and turning that into, production, into productive energy.
I mean, it's interesting. I think you wouldn't do a project like this if you didn't care. Both of you probably could do much more mainstream, easy projects and make a ton of money, but this definitely feels like...
Maybe. I'm at a certain level, which I'm really blessed to be at, and I feel like I've worked really hard here.
Wait till Jurassic World 3 comes on your plate.
We'll see if the studios come calling. But I make a certain type of film, and I think my films are... I don't think my films are difficult. I mean, they're certainly difficult to get made, just because any independent film is difficult to get made. Any film that's outside of the system is difficult.
Sure.
This is all made completely... independently. We don't use the word. Indie film gets thrown around.
It is a very weird thing. This is like $15 million, $25 million films are independent.
That gets thrown around. But this was a true independent film, and that's always difficult. But at the same time, I don't think my films are difficult to watch. I think my films. You're not getting a national theatrical release of a film, which we are. If you made a difficult film, I'm sure other people can, but my films are. I try to make them entertaining. I believe in the E word. I believe in entertainment. I believe in making people laugh, making people feel, making people cry, and connecting with people. That's what I want to do. I want to connect with the audience. I want them to feel something. I don't care what it is. I want them to feel some kind of connection to their life or to Lee's life or to Sam or to, anything. So, that's the goal there. That's the kind of films that I want to see and that I like to make.
I think that's a fantastic thing, especially with the numerous umpteenth sequels and stuff that are coming out these days. I feel like just people do not focus on just trying to connect with the audience.
If at the end of the day, all those movies live on their relationships. Even the big movie, even these big movies, the good ones have great relationships in them. They can surround it with the genre stuff, and I love that stuff.
Yeah.
But the good ones at work, movies like Logan. Mm-hmm. That works because of the connection between those characters, and that's all I'm doing. I don't have the $100 million to play with yet, but
just make sure you remember Sam when that day comes.
Well, Sam has always been a big believer in me, so I look at him because he tells me often that he thinks I'm gonna get there one day, and I hope he's right. But I think that at the end of the day, what matters in this world is the connections and the relationships you have with people. And that's what we make movies about. That's what Dreams was about. That's what this film was about. And I think people relate to that and connect with it. And what's better than connecting with just people? That's the whole point of this stuff. Yeah.
So the film is The Hero. It's playing at SIFF. Is there a website or any dates you want people to know in case they want to see the film?
Sure. The film comes out June 9th in New York and L.A., and it'll expand nationwide by June 30th. It should be here in Seattle probably in mid-June.
Excellent.
You can follow us on Facebook at Facebook.com/TheHeroMovie. We're on Twitter at TheHeroMovie17, and we're on Instagram at TheHeroMovie.
Excellent.
And you can follow all updates about the film and what cities it's coming out in and the whole thing.
Thank you so much, Brett and Sam, for doing this. And hopefully we'll see you again in another 2 years at SIFF with something new.
Because
it is all about connecting. You guys do an excellent job.
Thanks, Spencer. So appreciate it.
Thank you so much. Magneto can't stop me. I'm on fire tonight. Even Zod can't stop me. I'm on fire tonight. Don't even try to buy the Mr. Spock can't stop me. I'm on fire tonight. The Wrath of Khan can't stop me. I'm on fire tonight. The Borg can't stop me. I'm on fire tonight. Because I've got space game and it feels alright.